you are taking this as a commitment. Before taking, close your eyes and think. Who are you think as your worst enemy? Can you heal if that person comes for healing? If he comes without damaging your property or your personality, can you heal him? And now, if you can say yes, then let's go for next oath. Otherwise, class ends now. Close your eyes. You know, you don't have to say yes to me because you are not committing to me. You understand? So even if you don't heal tomorrow, I am not going, not even going to. No, it is to yourself. Please close your eyes and take few minutes and literally think, honestly check, can you really be so loving, compassionate, forgiving your worst enemies? Yes. Please now decide very clearly. It is you are deciding. Understand, you are taking the oath for yourself. And one more thing, be very clear. All these oaths are only for yourself. You are not doing it for me. You are not giving the promise to me. You are giving it to yourself. I don't want to take any promise from you because tomorrow if you don't follow it, you will feel guilty to see me. Or you will feel guilty to think about me. I don't want to create any guilt in you. It is for yourself. If you follow it, otherwise up to you. And I don't want to make you feel guilty. It is up to you. It is your responsibility. Because love plays a major role in healing. Love plays a major role in healing. How many of you slept peacefully yesterday night? Oh God, yeah, that's a big number. Dreamless sleep, you will have. The dreamless sleep. This yesterday's meditation technique is so powerful. Straight away you will fall into the sleep. Actually, that meditation is directly related to this causal body. It can put you into causal body. And the causal body is related to peace and love. Being loving or compassionate is a basic condition for healing. Understand? For your regular life, it is an option. You can be loving. It's like a morality. But here it is not. Morality is a basic condition. You have to be compassionate. Next oath. All of you, I think, read all these things now. If you have any question, you can ask me.
Swamiji, when we heal animals, do we think of chakras?
No. Just put your hand on the head. That's all.
On the head.
That's all. That's enough. And then there's one more thing, important thing. Inanimate, it says. You may think, how can inanimate things be healed? But I don't know whether it is, whether you can believe it or not. Any laptop gets repaired in the ashram, straight away it comes to my hand only. One blow and starts working. And in one of our devotees in Thiruvannamalai, his money counting machine did not work. And he repaired 2-3 times, it did not work. And just he started healing and 10 minutes it started working. Please understand, I am not spreading any superstition. I am not telling any lie. It's not one person's experience. Hundreds of experience I am hearing. Computer started working, Swamiji's cell phone started working, grinder started working, mixie started working. camera started working in Himalayas. And what not? Camcorder got discharged. Some important scene, we wanted to videograph. And just I held that battery. And it started showing the charging. It started showing, huh?
Went from 0 to 80%.
0 to 80%. And we recorded that scene also. We recorded that scene. And not only that, not once, thrice. Thrice. Then I said, in future you don't need pluck, bring it and put it on the field. And you see, it is not that it is done in private, in front of some 70 people. 70 people are there.
Yeah, teachers training.
Teachers training. 70 people are there. And the camcorder battery shows zero. And the moment I touched, and I held in the hand, and one small girl was there. And she said, Swamiji, now we don't have pluck, but we wanted to video record what you are speaking, please recharge and give. And just took that in the hand very casually. And it started showing the number changing. 1, 2, 3, tuck, 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 and it kept way to 80%. Understand? What all healing can do? I don't know. And not one or two, once or at least three times, the same thing. Then I said, record this scene itself. They video recorded that scene also. That scene also. Just the camcorder clearly showing, getting recharged. And it is going, that number is changing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it goes to 80.
Swamiji, with some people, no, whatever they touch stops working.
Means she is negative healer. She has got TPS should be too high, maybe too high. Etheric body has got some strong negative yantra.
These animals also have the...
Yes. But not so much developed like ours. But there is a... numbers are same, but it's not developed.
Plants
don't have chakras, but you can heal them. They respond to healing energy. So many plants, even in your house, Nama? What that flower?
White Nandiyavatta flower.
Nandiyavatta flower.
There were two identical plants, you know, the white Nandiyavatta, you call it in Tamil. One was flowering fully and the other didn't have any flowers in it. So then...
not even a single flower.
Not even a single flower. Both same height, everything identical. Then I did healing for it for I think about 5-6 days. And then that had more flowers than the other plant. And Swamiji happened to visit home at that time. So then we showed that plant to Swamiji and then...
Our Siddhi Sitachi was in NSP. Actually, first I discovered the plants can be healed in her house only. I was staying in her house. She attended our... I was sleeping.
Yes.
In her house, there was some novel tree. Novel English, I don't know the word. Jamun tree. Which was not giving fruits for 10 years. 10 years it did not give fruits. And when we went to, when I was staying in her house, 10 days I stayed in her house. In those days I used to stay in devotee's house for 10 days and all. Nowadays, 10 minutes only. If I go there, 10 minutes, pour the water in the feet and put some vibhuti kumkum and put one garland and do one aarti and start. 10 minutes only. Those days, 2 years ago, I was staying in her house. For 10 days, that time she, when we were going for evening walk, her house is a big house and there is the Budralaya. Horses, where horses are trained? Horse stable. Inside the house, they have got horse stable. So I was going around in the horse stable and evening, for evening walk and they wanted me to sit on the horse, but I didn't sit. I said no. But I went around inside the horse stable, I was going for a walk. Then casually she told me, Swamiji, this tree is not giving fruit. Why don't you do something? I said, what can be done to the tree? Human beings can be healed. How can trees be healed? No, Swamiji, you just touch. She said, I said, well, all right, anyhow, our faith, I can't say no. I just went and touched. When I was walking, I touched the tree casually. Let it give fruit. 10 days before I came out, it gave fruit and she brought the fruit to the ashram. She brought the fruit to the ashram. From that day still it is giving fruits. It's continuously giving fruits. And she says, it is giving fruits in the non-season also, Swamiji. And it doesn't know any season or anything. Just simply it gives the fruit. It simply gives the fruits all the time. She's telling, no season. First time I discovered the healing can be worked on plants. Before that, I also didn't have an idea. Then I saw not only me, our healers are also working on the plants everywhere. The other day, and Guru Purnima day, if you see, I was wearing the long lemon garland. If you saw?
Yes, yes.
The lemon garland. That's also from one devotee only. He was having lemon plants, but no fruit is coming. And he started healing near Rasipuram only, near Patnam only. He started healing. Simply the lemon started coming like anything. He brought the first bunch of lemon. He made a garland and brought it on the Guru Purnima day. And one devotee, the Yerkai. LHC, same day. It was not
Kadamam.
In English, what is
Kadamam?
Kadamams. And he did not have the LHC property in his land. He started healing by himself. After healing initiation, he started healing. He got the Kadamam. And he brought equivalent to my weight. And the problem is, he is not happy if I touch it and bless. He started putting it on my head. Like a Abhishekam. When I went to Madurai, he started just pouring it on me. And I said, I will touch it and why don't he leave me? But only when he filled the whole thing on me, he was satisfied. Then whomsoever came for darshan, I told him, take it little bit prasad. Take little less prasad. People have started carrying in the cloth, some this much, then exhausted. 60, 70 kg, he brought and poured it on me. I said, why did you bring so much? You bring little this much, I can use it in the ashram. He said, no, Swamiji, I've just grown at least thrice. Usually what comes? Three times more it has come this season. So, healing can do miracles, wonders. He says, and one more thing, I am always against the pesticide and this chemicals. Usually if the chemicals are stopped, the growth will be less. The what is it, products will be naturally less. He stopped all the pesticides and chemicals. But the three times more, he got yield, he had the yield. So he brought and put so much on me. Healing can do wonders and miracles. And one of our organizers in Pudukkote, Chinnaya, her sister is there. His sister is there. Her brother, in her house, there was a white ants in the cupboard. Tell you, Achin? White ants in the cupboard. 2-3 times they are continuously putting all chemicals, but the white ants are not disappearing. Termites. It's not disappearing. Continuously. Every year, again and again, it comes back. And then she decided, now what to do? She started healing the cupboard. And you'll be surprised, in 1 month, all the termites stop. And she says, last 6 months, no termites. So, what all healing can do? I don't know. So, animate or inanimate, you can do miracles with healing energy. Then I understood, actually, first it was difficult for me also to believe inanimate beings be healed. Then, once I read the Einstein, then I understood, there is nothing called matter in the planet Earth. Everything is energy. Different intensity, that's all. See, when the intensity is different, you call that as a stone, rock, matter. You call all those things when the intensity is different, that's all. So, computer is also energy only.
Swamiji, that means you understand the theory of relativity.
Yes.
And they say only some 2 or 3 people on earth that understand.
And these people who did research on my head, they were telling, if the frontal lobe is active, 150%, 150% itself, a person will become scientist. Here they say 700% it is active. Seven times more than a normal human being. In one family, Pierre's room, Steve was not working. She went and healed, he started working. And second time also, again she went and healed, he started working. So in your house, if TV gets repaired, don't ask electrician. Anyhow, let me describe only one simple way what research you are going to do. See, according to string theory and physics, the length, breadth, depth cannot be teleported. it can be taken moved only as a together. See, for example, the length, breadth and depth of this mic, either you completely move it or completely leave it. This is the string theory. This is the physics. This is the, that's why they say the quantum physics is not, then teleporting is not possible. The end of the string theory. The according to physics, that is why they say teleporting is not possible. But according to spirituality, it is possible. According to our yogic science, it is possible. I tell them length and breadth can be left here, depth can be teleported. Then you will see the mic, but your hand will not hit the mic. Your hands can go and come. And same way, depth can be left here, length and breadth can be moved there. Then you will not see the mic. If you put the hand, something will hit. I told them the length and breadth and depth can be disintegrated and moved separately and assembled. They said it is simply impossible. I challenged them. I'll do it. Get all your scientists. Get all your scientists. Get a cup. I'll show you how the cup can move here. That cup can come here. But get the whole group. And get Kirlian photography. Kirlian photography, you can, through Kirlian photography you can see. You can see that how it is moving. You see, through ordinary eyes you can't see. But through Kirlian photography is like an X-ray. Very deeper level X-ray. Anybody knows about the Kirlian photography?
Has it been taken on your aura?
Yes. Yes, they have taken on my aura. Tell about that?
No.
They took on my aura. The Kirlian photography says neither the head nor the tail will be measured. The Kirlian photography was not able to measure that. Aura, it says no. And it just started beeping. Bis. They are not able to measure the length and breadth. They say that maximum some 70-80 feet they can measure. But they are not able to measure the length or neither the head nor the tail. They are not able to measure the both the points of Kirlian photography. That is different. That's okay. Leave it. What I am saying, I told get the Kirlian photography. So that exactly you can see how the length, breadth, depth is teleported. That is the way the yogis are doing the teleporting. And you see, all this, whatever is given, it is not created. Be very clear, it is not created. It is just brought from the room. It is there in my room. Just it is. It comes to the hand. And it's like a cell phone wave. You see, cell phone wave, how you, if you speak here, the waves disappear and become sound wave. And it moves to the
receiver.
And there again that waves become sound waves. Same way that matter is disintegrated energy. And energy moves, energy again becomes matter. Of course, I never do that. Because it is cheap publicity. Somehow I feel all these things are not representation of spirituality. These are all just good magic. But not spiritual representing. I never usually, of course, I surrendered. Immediately after enlightenment, I stopped all these things. Before enlightenment, I used to like this simple one of things. In my wandering time, somewhere where some people are given a little vibhuti or one bana, one lemon. But after enlightenment, I stopped the whole thing.
Even Ramananda said the same thing.
Mm. After enlightenment, you will not be able to do all these things. But now for scientists, I can at least show that it is possible. It is possible for scientists as a scientific research.
In this way, can anything be repaired? Say, instrument gets broken, can it be repaired? The instrument got completely broken.
The big problem is, that is the reason I don't speak about all these things in the public. I've never spoken. The moment we speak, everybody wants all these things to be done.
No, sir, I want to just.
But it can be done. And usually, I trust in intelligence, I trust in spirituality. See, all these things, I always tell people, if I start doing all these things, nothing will happen to you. I will grow, but you will not grow. I may have bigger institution. I may have bigger things, but you will not have anything. My business will happen, your business will not happen. That's the reason I never have. But of course, I'll do it for the scientist people, so that it will be recorded forever. At least forever, that science will know that something more is possible by spirituality, just to prove the theory. We'll do it and publish it once for all, for the sake of world.